blame it on the hemness. Money, we made it. Yeah, but before we see it, they take it. Yeah, make it one holler. The way they do your life, make it wanna holler. The way they do your life gives God hand. What's happening, y'all? It's your boy DC Curry coming to you live from the ATL, from the new improved Uptown Comedy Corner. You listening to DISRACE, DISRACE, where our motto has always been no hate, but no fear. You got to know when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away.
And we never run.
We
never
do run. No running. Respect everybody.
Fear none.
And fear nobody. Respect all. And fear none. I got my main man, the chaplain, the Mohican minister. Ladies and gentlemen, show your love for Mr. Brian Harper, the Reverend, the right Reverend.
That's right.
As opposed to the wrong Reverend.
Exactly. You know what it is. Always winning, never losing.
Always winning, never losing, and never gambling.
Yeah. So I'm like the South Carolina Gamecocks, man. Female, you know, undefeated.
And you wouldn't bet on them.
I told you I do not gamble, but hey, if I was a gambler, I would have bet on
it. How do you think the Lord feel about this is money you can make and tithe out of it, but your scared ass won't bet?
He don't want me to come obsessed with it. He knows me. I would get, I'm too competitive.
You obsessing?
I would get obsessed with it on winning and losing.
Obsessive too, like that, of women and stuff?
Not at all.
Latch on and go crazy?
Nah.
Nah,
I don't do that. I'm not possessive. You can gas.
Can I call a witness up to the...
Sure.
Sure. I got my main man, Tim Black.
Tim Black in the building. How y'all doing? Is my mic on? How's it going? How's it going? Happy.
Is my mic on? He sound like preacher ain't getting no amen. Yeah, your mic on. Don't nobody know who the hell you are. He ain't hear no hand clap at me. I'm Tim Black. Yeah. Everybody like, who the hell is that? He's like, is my mic on?
Yeah. And then he went with Tim Black. I just told him, I said, man, what are you doing? He said, I got to slowly go into it. He didn't want to do Tim Black a little while ago.
You got to do it. You got to present it.
You got
to
present
it. I've been trying to tell him.
You got to present it. Like, you got to present it when the source is near. Like, you got to compliment him on his sweatpants. you gotta show him who's boss. You know?
He know how to come up in the company, boy.
So you Tim Black now?
He knows how to do it.
Bullshit.
Okay. Yes. Two, Tim Black, 3 Ks.
I'm so happy for you.
Tim Black. It's better than Black-ass Tim.
I like that.
Hey, you gonna do an interview on ABC. Coming up next, Black-ass Tim.
It'll never happen.
Coming up next, Tim Black.
That's good.
Oh, man, that might change it all right there.
That's going to change your
life,
boy.
It's going to change the game.
It's going to change your life right there.
Yeah, yeah. He going to put me in his will, y'all. I feel it.
And then when they introduce you. when they introduce you, then they show your picture, then everybody else says, damn, Black-ass Tim.
They going to change it over.
The Black Tim Black.
The Black Tim, right. Still gonna be Black.
The
ass.
Black.
Yeah,
Tim
let
Black.
Let us see it.
To my far left, sitting in for the wounded soldier, Vote P. Ladies and gentlemen, Weight Boss.
Yeah, happy to be here. Sorry, I'm in Vote P's seat, but I'm gonna be as.
It's all right,
as
man.
Vote P was.
It's all right. And but you know, I will say when Vote P is sitting there, we can see like some of the seat.
Oh, yeah, no. All this seat is full of ass today. This seat got way more ass in it than it used to.
This seat like, damn.
Let him know, Weight Ball. Let him know. But we glad to have you, boy.
Let him know, Weight Ball.
I got Bullhead, our Muslim enthusiast and professional, and I don't even think you're real Muslim. But anyway, you know all the information.
You say Muslim.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bullhead.
Assalamu alaikum. And for the whole Muslim world today, Eid Mubarak.
What
today,
that mean?
Today is equivalent to Christmas for the Muslims.
Okay. Ramadan, right?
Yeah.
I'll come back Eid. To that. I'm sorry about Ramadan's that. I'm sorry over. About the little incident okay. in Philadelphia, but I'll get back to you on that.
Okay.
They had a shootout in Philadelphia, disrupted the whole Ramadan.
Yeah.
And it wasn't about Ramadan, supposedly. It was about, they were just fighting with each other, but having to be Ramadan.
Mm.
Oh, well.
Several people shot.
We got special guests from all the way from Augusta, Georgia, ladies and gentlemen. Cookie Hub.
I ain't got no mic, but I'm back here.
In walks Carla.
What's up, Carla?
Y'all can't hear. She ain't got no mic, but she said she missed me.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's yeah, what she said.
She,
she didn't say she missed y'all. She said she missed
you.
Me.
Okay.
Right.
All
right.
Hey.
And no
said
sandwiches.
She missed everybody.
No sandwiches again.
Well, good to see y'all. I take it y'all witnessed the eclipse.
No.
Are you one of those people?
Man, whatever, man. It was no different than the clouds.
See?
I'm going to tell you something, man. Mm-hmm. I really wasn't into watching.
Right.
But it happened to be.
What?
Were you in Texas?
No. I was here.
Oh, you were in the area in totality.
But when the other people were looking at it, they had the glasses on, and they was like, oh, you ain't gonna believe this. And I said, give me them damn glasses.
Mm-hmm.
And I put them glasses, it was really something to see.
Yeah.
Really, so I missed out.
You missed out, bro.
It won't happen for another.
It was something to see. In the middle of the day, with your naked eye, you couldn't see nothing. But if you put them eclipse glasses on, you could actually see the moon coming over in front of the sun.
So now, DC, when you say that, there's another group of people that I remember Charles Barkley during halftime, during the national game, said, shout out to all them idiots who just looking up in the sky, watching it get dark. So now, do you feel that you were part of something special, or is this just another?
I'm saying it was something to see. It caught me off guard because I was like that was my thing before I actually saw it. And when I saw it, I mean, you know how I be thinking, all kind of shit started going through my mind. Rev, I started thinking about the crucifixion when Jesus was crucified and the sun refused to shine. Mm-hmm. I'm saying God did it, but he could have done it by way of an eclipse.
Right, because you said
sun
it was dark
and the crucifixion
was dark, and the veil was broken. And
it could have been.
Yeah.
You know, it was from 3 o'clock in the evening to 6 o'clock. Right. Jesus supposedly died at 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Right.
And from 3 to 6, sun refused to shine. He could have, I'm not saying God didn't do it, I'm saying God could have caused the eclipse.
Yeah, it just puts you in the mind of
and
that.
Shut
I understand
the sun down for 3 hours. Yeah. I mean, I thought thinking about all kind of shit. Man, when I actually saw it.
Okay.
I mean, I actually, with them glasses.
Saw the moon go in front of sun.
And I took pictures. They say you couldn't take pictures. What I did, I'm telling you, man.
You put the glasses over the.
Boy! Oh, I put the glasses on my phone. And then I took the picture. I show them to y'all on the bridge.
Yeah. Okay. I
put the
check
glasses on my phone. And it ain't clear as I can see it, but it's.
You got it.
Now,
what does the next one do?
Nah.
54 years?
40 years, something like that. You'll be 90.
I'll make that.
90.
I'll make that. Always winning.
I'll make that.
I will say is, I agree with you on all the spirituality, but I disagree on the fact that you couldn't do nothing with your naked eye. Like, literally, I forgot it was an eclipse.
Yeah.
Like, I had been reading about it, I heard about it, but then, you know, I'd be off the grid. So I'm just working from home. But I work from home in front of a big window. So I'm just looking out the window like, this is the weirdest looking sky I ever seen.
It was hazy.
You're going to see a difference, but you wasn't going to see the
Well, you say, it was sepia.
I was like, it was a blue sky, but it wasn't blue. I was like, it looked like it was about to storm. I'm like,
it was
Lord,
like gray.
What's going on, gray. Lord? So even with me out, without me looking at the moon.
You said, Lord.
I say, Lord, what's going on?
And I know Lord said, who the fuck is this?
He's like, you're the only nigga that ain't been looking at the news.
Right. In my neighborhood now, what I did notice, when I looked up, it got real dim, it got real cloudy, but all the birds kind of just stopped chirping. Yeah, they started chilled out. My crackheads on my little street, they all scurried in.
Yeah.
It was all. It was a whole little moment for about.
Man.
Everybody, all the animals kind of took a nap for about 30 minutes.
It was something.
It just got a little bit reddish in Midtown. To me, it's just like a little bit
Midtown.
Reddish.
But Midtown, everybody in Midtown's halfway, so you got half the eclipse.
And then it's a whole rainbow. So
right.
When you block out the sun, it affects the rainbow a little different. Then you say, he saw red. The sun blocked out all the other colors of the rainbow, but only the red.
Did you see the eclipse, since JJ?
I didn't see it through the
glasses.
Mm-mm.
You miss them.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, man. I mean, I had planned to miss it. I'm like, give a damn about no.
A friend of mine she did the same thing. She showed it on Facebook.
What he say?
There ain't no UV lashes like you could just. I know they got some eclipse lashes out. They had no.
I need to tell the people, wait, Bob been drinking.
Got this shine.
It's on him, man.
But it was something, man. I didn't realize it was going to be as big of an event as it was for white people. Oh, boy, yeah. The Mexicans was in Mexico, I guess.
Yeah, Mexico. That's where they were at.
Mazatlan.
Or close by.
I'm saying when the eclipse came by there. Man, it got pitch black.
Well, there was only a path, so the path was from Mexico through Dallas up towards Maine.
The totality path.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, I'm going to tell you something, man, because y'all know my theory about them going to the moon and stuff.
All right.
I don't believe they went.
Exactly.
I don't believe they went. Ain't no gravity on the moon, but the moon rock sitting there while they ain't floating.
That's
around.
Not.
Ain't no gravity. But anyway, to reiterate my point, I heard them talking about the eclipse and all about the moon. The moon travels 2,000 miles an hour, I think it is.
Mm-hmm.
You can Google it, I don't know. The Earth travels 67,000 miles an hour. How in the hell you fly a vehicle, take off from a planet that's moving 67,000 miles an hour, and land where you want to on another? I don't know what the moon is. It ain't no star.
I believe
it ain't no planet. That moving 2,000 miles out.
Rocket science. You got to be a rocket scientist.
Rocket science. Oh yeah, my daughter's dated a few of those. All of them. I'd be like, bitch, is you crazy? That nigga ain't no rocket science.
Right. No. He be high. He be high all the time.
Right. I used to tell him I was a rocket scientist. Oh, rocket scientist line.
You know,
rocket science. That's the only shit in the book, boy.
Up until I was working with you guys, I was kind of on the other side saying, like, nah, what is DC talking about? Then when he started pointing out some stuff, I was like, I really switched my opinion by being on this show.
Ladies and gentlemen, a convert.
Look at that. Go and walk.
And what I want to say is that.
Give your life to DC.
They never take pictures of, like, they say they landed, but then how did they get the buggy back here? Like how did they get the buggy? You know, because if you go to the Smithsonian, I think they got the so-called moon buggy.
His best point on this fact is that if we've been to the moon, why ain't we been back? That's really the best. I know that.
But there are other things now that you can bring like how did y'all get the buggy back? And if you didn't bring it back,
why the rocks
and everything? Yeah, and why the flag? Why the flag was going straight and not going up? Why the flag wasn't on?
Why the flag wasn't going up?
Yeah,
why
going
the flag
up.
Going sideways?
Exactly. So
and how you get enough fuel?
Well, that has something to do with the gravitational pull.
The moon is 250,000 miles from here, approximately.
Right.
The sun is almost 100 million miles. The sun is 400 times the distance. However, the sun is also 400 times as large as the moon. The diameter of the moon, if I'm not mistaken, is a couple thousand miles. Diameter of the Earth.
This nigga is a scientist.
The diameter, I be reading. The diameter of the
Earth. Exactly.
The diameter of the Earth is 10,000 miles.
Yes.
But you tell me how you can land a rocket on the moon, even if it's only a fifth of the size of the Earth, and in the background of the supposed landing, you can see the curvature of the planet. If you land anywhere on Earth, ain't no way in hell you can see. You got
that's
to
cause
be.
Earth is flat.
I used to fly.
That's what NASA means, flat Earth.
Uh-huh. You got Kyrie Irving in the building.
Kyrie Irving in the building.
We'll be back. You're listening to DISRACE. All right. It changed a lot of things too. The eclipse did, man. Because I got some chickens that normally lay 2 or 3 eggs a day, and I guess they thought it was night, so the heifers laid an extra egg.
I was going to ask you
because it got dark,
eggs.
and then you know, 5 minutes later it got light.
So the chickens laid the egg, or the heifers laid the egg?
Well,
I'm confused with the
talking,
cow talking.
I'm talking the heifers, you know, okay. The hens, you know, heifer the cow with hen. But I'm wondering, with regards to that, would it change a woman's cycle?
Why are you looking at me?
I'm about to say he's looking over there.
It ain't you. He's looking over there. He looking over there. Just trying to see if they got any advice on
it. Y'all have
any
medical effects from the eclipse?
I didn't know. I didn't hear any women saying that they had any medical effects or their cycle.
You didn't
change.
Hear none. What about you? You a woman?
Y'all not gonna know my business.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna just go out there and say I've been emotional over the last couple of days. I don't know what it been. I've been tripping. I don't know what it been. I've been tripping the last couple of days.
Bullshit.
It might have something to do with that eclipse.
Eclipse was something to see, man.
They did say people were going to act strange.
Yeah, they was acting strange.
Man, there's no difference in here.
Man, white people were excited.
They, like, I never seen before.
They're always excited.
But the news had it playing live.
Yeah.
The news even had it going live on YouTube. Like, I just,
no,
I couldn't get off the
channel.
Tube.
I saw
they had some white people that
emotional.
Paid, I think it was $1,500. They were trying to fly to the totality place where the eclipse was going to be.
People from all over the world.
And the flight was late.
That's what they get.
So the pilot was on the plane trying to angle the plane so they could see the eclipse.
That's what they get.
From cool. The plane.
Keep on messing with that.
White people are in love.
I don't know why white people get this traveling money. Like, I've seen white people take... they, like, take 6 months off. Like, they be like, they gonna get themselves together.
Yeah.
I mean, they be like... They be like waiters and shit. They be like... I'm gonna take 6 months off and get myself
now,
together.
A man in your financial position, are you not allowed the 3 to 4 months to just find yourself?
Man, if I don't work this weekend, I'll be evicted.
And this, you wonder because you see people or you see Caucasians, they can just take 2 weeks or a month off and they just go sit on a glacier.
You gotta call them. It's DISRACE, man. You ain't gotta call them Caucasians.
Yeah.
Okay, what do you mean?
I noticed that. But I'm saying, man, these were like regular people, and they had paid $1,600 for these plane tickets to go see the moon get in the way of the sun.
It's just throwing them. It's just
they're
they just got
the
money
experience.
To burn, man.
But I'm just saying, where do these white people get their money from?
Yeah, it's like, well, you know, they could probably just walk in the bank and say, "It's the eclipse. I need $5,000." Sure, no problem. You don't need no collateral.
You gonna pay us back, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay,
hey, you ain't got to sign for it. We got you. Just walk out.
My thing is, I understand it's a once in a lifetime opportunity, but if you're the type that's gonna jump on an expensive plane and go see an eclipse, and you don't even own a telescope at your house. Like, then to me, you on some bullshit.
Right.
Like,
I got a telescope.
You supposed to have a telescope. Like,
y'all should get a telescope. Y'all
got a telescope. That's a start.
Do you have a telescope?
Well, I had one. My granddaddy gave me one when I was little. I don't have it no more.
You pawned it?
Well, it was a long time ago. I don't know.
Back in the day, I used to give, you know, like, when I was in Hollywood, I knew a lot of rich people. This is a true story. Mm. But you know, you don't think about rich people's children. They don't get nothing because everybody be like, he already got everything. Mm-hmm. So I had this thing, what I would do, the rich people I knew, and I knew their children, that's what I would give their children for Christmas.
Telescopes.
That's a great gift.
It's a great gift.
I gave Ice Cube's son telescope. He probably threw that son bitch away.
Oh, shit.
But that's what I would do. And it would be amazing to watch the reaction of the children of these rich people. But they would be just like any other kid when they got a gift for Christmas, man. They'd be like,
I
don't believe this nigga gave me something. And I'd be like, don't worry, I'll get back from your daddy on next Friday.
in the next fiscal year.
I'm about to get paid. I'm about to get like 500 telescopes.
But back in the day, I mean, I don't know, when I was a kid, our parents did used to do like the telescopes and the chemistry sets and stuff like that. But Now you give a child a telescope.
Yeah, good telescope too. I don't give away.
The big ones, the big ones.
The big one, man. Oh. On the tripod. Yeah. Everything.
I got one of them. I'd be looking at my neighbors.
It turned you into a peeping Tom.
You might not need to tell people where you live. The police gonna be at your door.
But I think the eclipse did rejuvenate the interest in science and everything, man.
Yeah,
but it was an interesting occurrence all the way around. I got the biggest kick out just watching the people, man. How excited the white people were.
They love were outdoors.
Excited. Excited about the moon.
For
getting in the way of the sun.
You know, for a culture that supposedly, quote unquote, can't take the sun, they definitely make it their business to be out there a lot and explore stuff.
Like, well, you gotta understand
that. No tanning for 5 minutes.
Exactly. Yeah. Couldn't tan for 5 minutes.
White people get excited about a lot of different things. I go rock climbing on the weekends and I see a lot of white people ask me if I'm in there to steal the trees. They don't know what the fuck my ass is. They don't know why my black ass is there. But they love outside. They like to get lost. You know there's a feature on the Apple Watch.
I like outside.
Yeah, but there's a feature on the Apple Watch now. For white people, for when they get lost. So you know how to get.
Only for white people?
Well, we don't go out into the woods and just walk around.
You ever seen a nigga on
I'm doing it.
Naked and Afraid?
Too many trees out there.
Oh, that's different.
Naked and Afraid?
They different.
You think you can make it?
Hell no, because I ain't scared of shit.
You could go. You out there for 30 days naked and just make a.
Well, you ain't by yourself. Who taking the camera? Who taking the picture?
Yeah.
Just like on the moon. Who took the picture?
Right. I'm trying to find out where you go rock climbing other than stone mountain.
No.
But hold on, let's go back though. DC, they can't help you though.
Huh?
When you said naked and afraid, okay, the cameraman can't help you
though.
But
that's a lie.
So you think the cameraman gonna let you die?
Right.
Why are you coming for me,
yeah.
Brian?
It's the truth. He was about to say the same thing I said.
Yeah, he can't. He can't help you.
Oh, he's gonna help you. He's not gonna let you die.
Thank you.
He's out there in the woods with you.
And I watch.
You naked. First place, he's a freak. Ooh, what's the topic?
I like watching Naked and Afraid because I just like watching white people seek out struggle.
It's just goofy to me.
Just out there in the woods, butt naked. You know, and when something does happen.
What's the thing? What are we naked in the woods for? Be out there. It's dangerous enough in your clothes. What the hell you want to be out here naked for? You want to have some old extra freaky deaky shit, too.
Those are the true elements. That's Adam and Eve. That's how we started.
You were born naked.
I think everybody could at least have some pants naked. And drawers on.
We were all born naked, right?
I hope you had enough. Guys.
I hope you were born naked, Bullhead. That's right.
Oh, yeah. I was born on a kitchen table at a mosque.
Naked no, on
not
the kitchen
what you
table.
Was going on.
Absolutely
what
naked.
Was my dad would slap your ass, boy. Go put some clothes on this, in the kitchen.
This dude has no
now,
power.
I would say, if I was on Naked and Afraid and I was butt naked and that cameraman was eating some Doritos, I would threaten him. With rubbing my naked ass on his ass. I'm like, if you don't want to be all up on me, if you don't want to feel this sweat face to face, I'll be chasing the cameraman.
Well, now they say, when you go on Naked and Afraid, a person of your size is good because you after 30 days, you can just.
Boy, that boy good. You hear what he said? A person of your size?
As opposed to
a fat motherfucker.
Well, you know, some people would say a person of your stature. Some people would say stature.
Yeah.
You know, it's other ways to say it too, other than fat motherfucker.
No, I thought that was very clever. No, go ahead, would. Tim. I'm sorry.
But it's ideal because you stored a lot of food inside of you. And for those 30 days, you don't have to struggle. Like
that's not true, because a person of my size, just imagine somebody skinny as you. It's only so many places a mosquito could bite your ass. Now, I'm out here with all this surface area. You can just imagine the amounts of bites and stings that I'm going to have. I got no money to succumb to this damn sting.
Touché, my friend, touché.
More ways to get malaria. I'm with Weight Ball.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know how I got off on that, but anyway.
Yay. You got the calm.
Something about the eclipse.
In black community and in history and so forth, aside from the fake news that we went to the moon, it is a fact that 50 years ago last week, Hank Aaron broke Babe Ruth's home run record.
Mobile, Alabama's own.
Yeah. Now that was eclipsing right there, wasn't it?
Hammering Hank Aaron.
Yeah. Mobile, Alabama's own.
And you know when I always always watch when he hit number 715, he running around the bases with all the hype about him breaking the record, with all of the death threats he got, you know, from the white racist people about him breaking the record. When the man rounded second base, two white boys. I think about this every time
came
I see
out.
It.
Right.
They let them two white boys
come out,
get up on him.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, luckily they were congratulating
friendly,
him. But you're going to let, with death threats and all that, you're going to let two white boys
jump
out.
Yeah, that's the scene. I've just remembered that. That's wild.
And run up on the man. And
patting
they,
him
they
and congratulating
touching
him.
Him. They touching him, man.
He's rounding the bases.
As he rounded the base between
and getting patted
second
on his
and
head
third
by
and
two random white men.
With all
never hit
the
a home
hype,
run.
With all the death threats. And so I got Bo P doing a segment before he fell and busted his ass or whatever.
Yeah.
And the segment that I want him to bring every week is if they had been black.
Right.
Oof.
And if Hank had been white and them, the white boy been getting death threats and two niggas jumped out the stand.
To congratulate him?
Oh, yeah.
And ran up to him as he was rounding the bases.
Oh, yeah.
Breaking Babe Ruth's record.
Yeah.
It would have been worse than Dexter Reed in Chicago, the video they showed, and they shot at the boy 96 times.
That's
they
crazy.
Say they pulled him over, a tactical plainclothes unit in Chicago pulled him over for a seatbelt violation, which I know is a lie, because they showed the boy Dexter Reed trying to roll the window up. He rolled it up. The window was tinted black as Tim. There is no way in hell they pulled him over for a seatbelt violation. They couldn't see him in the car, let alone the seatbelt. Now, I don't know what was going on, but that was straight bullshit. I don't believe he had no gun. I saw the video. I don't believe he fired the first shot. Because if I'm in a car and I'm trying to shoot my way out of there, and the car's still running, I ain't going to put it in park and shoot.
Right.
I'm gonna put it in, they pull it in front of him. I'm putting it in reverse, and I'm gonna shoot as I try to get the hell out of there.
Exactly.
He shot, then got out the car without the gun.
Exactly.
What?
Right. Don't make no sense, man.
And they fired off 96 rounds. Yeah, we'll be 96. Back if we live. You listening to DISRACE.
Damn.
All right, we're back. I threw it out there, but it deserves a segment, man. Dexter Reed in Chicago last month, shot by the Chicago Police Department. Plainclothesman, let me give you a scenario. 5 plainclothesmen riding in an unmarked police car. Pull his brother over here in a white SUV. Tell him roll window down. He rolled down at first. Then he's like, you know, why y'all got y'all guns out and stuff? So he started rolling the window back up and locked his door. Police, open the door. Anyway, then they turned their body cam on after they got out of the car. They claim it was a routine seatbelt violation, which is, I know that's a lie, because his windows at the point when they stopped him were up and the windows were tinted and you couldn't see through the window. So it wasn't no seatbelt violation. Then they claim he shot at them first. And you got 5 policemen surrounding your car with their guns pointed at you. I doubt if he thought he could shoot his way out of that.
Right.
Right. You shouldn't even feel like
he
got
out the car without his gun, according to the videos that they showed. Got out the car without his gun. They claim later they found his gun on the inside of the car. And then he came around the back of the car, and they fired 96 shots between time he got out and time he got to the back. 96 shots at killed the boy, Dexter Reed.
It's so overwhelming and unimaginable, but let me ask you this. Do you think that because it's been such a space between the last police shooting, do you think that as a society we kind of forgot and that's why they think they can get away with something so extreme, so overt?
That shit happens so often. How can you forget? How can you forget Laquan McDonald shot in the back 16 times 3 years ago by Chicago police? He ain't had nothing but a pocket knife. How can you forget when yesterday the goon squad in Mississippi was sentenced?
Oh, for
6
what?
Of them.
Absolutely.
Just went in and raped a man. Supposedly he was sleeping with the white woman.
Over. Right.
So how can you forget?
Well, what needs to happen is exactly what happened in Mississippi. These guys need to get sterner laws. A lot of police officers, you get a vacation most of the time.
They're on paid leave in Chicago.
Yeah, you're on paid leave. So you get a vacation.
That's a vacation.
And then amongst that, certain people in this world going to send GoFundMe to them. They already make, the guy that shot my man up in, Michael up, was that in Detroit? Carl Durrell, the police officer, shot the young man for just having a cigarillo or whatever. You know, these people make money. These cops get money in GoFundMe. So me killing an unarmed black man or an armed black man is kind of like, man, this is kind of a come up. And I don't know what politician, I'm just being honest with you, I don't know what kind of politician or what we got to do to force them, but they got to make sterner, harsher laws on these police officers. Period. That's the only way it's going to stop. And not marching, not violence on violence, not economically. You got to, like, make an example to all these police officers who do that.
You think if black men started defending themselves against the police, the situation would only get worse?
Yeah.
Well, I'm not
going
to encourage that.
Yeah, I'm not encouraging. I just think you just need the lawmakers need to just drop the hammer on these guys. That you go on, even if you don't get fired off the force, you're just not getting paid until this thing is over with.
You're asking such an extreme, you're asking something of a society that has not changed since the beginning. It ain't gonna happen.
Well,
my thing
if
is
we keep
even,
saying it ain't gonna happen, it's not gonna happen.
And then the other part is you're saying it's been a long time since you've seen one. That's all media driven.
Absolutely.
It ain't been a long time.
What they gonna put on front or what they gonna sweep under
and
the rug and what's not
to
gonna get publicity.
That he was in the game. That's why I asked who he was, because I've been like researching a lot of the gangsters in Chicago. And just some of the things, a project that I'm working on, and that's why I was asking what his name was, because the first thing they're going to try to say is gang-related, but something of that magnitude that tells you that is definitely some street stuff that's going on. For them to do that in the open,
hey, plus you got to ask, a question: why you got 5 police officers in one car?
It was a tactical unit. But you ain't out looking for seatbelts.
No, that's my point.
They were specifically
They weren't just regular patrol officers, for a seatbelt violation. You got 5 detectives because they were plainclothes.
Yeah.
That means they're detectives.
Yeah.
They're not out there trying to Well, their job is in
they're
the
not street. I know you, they're not doing traffic stops.
Right. They're looking for gang members and drug dealers and other stuff.
At the risk of sounding racist, which I'm not. When you going to kill an innocent white man?
Oh, that's not going to happen.
When you going to pull a white teenager over?
Right.
And he pull out his mobile phone and you think it's a 9mm. Right. When that going to happen? Nah.
But what's so hard about punishing the police officers? I mean, we just made a law to protect people from the LGBTQ community. So what is so hard about punishing police officers?
But the thing is, historically, rape has never been a high charge.
But what's like even when you hard said the
police the raped the man, like they gang squad raped the man. Rape has never been a real high charge, like compared to murder.
But what's hard about
they
making a law?
They shot him in the mouth. They shot one
he
him
lived.
In the mouth.
That's a problem. Right. I mean, my thing is, number one, rape is one thing. But if you rape a heterosexual man, that should be a higher charge.
Ho. What? Whether you are heterosexual
no,
or
I'm saying, if you do not
have the right to be violated whether you're heterosexual
but you can't.
Or whether you're gay.
No,
I believe you said
that. Rape all is so.
No.
Red, trust me.
No.
You don't want
no.
No.
No, I'm gonna step in.
Y'all book breaking. Y'all book breaking. In. That's different. That's different than
violation.
Gotcha.
Don't
violation
say shit.
Is violation.
The nerve of you, nigga.
Yeah.
To compare the rape of a woman, there's nothing worse than that.
No, I would say a woman who has had heterosexual sex before, raping her is gonna be better than raping me. Hell no, raping her gonna be way better than raping me. What y'all talking about? Hell no, I know I'm gonna be scarred for life. She might be able to come back from it, but I know I would never be able to come back from that. I would not be the same person.
Way bar.
He said,
I'm not gonna laugh at that shit.
I'm just saying.
On the air. Because that is the most ridiculous shit, ladies.
It's a difference.
That's the most ridiculous shit I've ever heard in my life. First place, I'm even gonna go against it. First place, as a man, I mean, if it's six policemen, I guess they all got guns, you know. But if you allow yourself to be raped, I don't know, you might. It might not
How
be
can you allow yourself to be raped?
Right, I agree.
But
How
there
you
is
yourself?
Nothing, brother. There's nothing worse than.
The vulnerability of a woman.
Rape,
it's nothing exactly, whether it's a man or a female. Violation is violation, whether you are heterosexual.
Well, violation is violation, but you know, I mean, they're awesome. I mean,
okay, but if you're
a man, right? I cannot imagine a woman ever wanting to be raped. No. But there are some women I'd be like, you can rape.
You know what?
Can't rape the willing.
You know what?
Yeah. You can't really rape the willing. The but I understand what these.
Way
say.
To bring the lightness in, bro.
I understand. I'm just
saying. Very few men report rape by women.
We understand rape
yeah,
is
I ain't
wrong
heard too many.
All the time. But you got to admit, it's levels of rape. Like if somebody rape a little baby.
No.
Keep it real. If somebody rape a baby versus somebody rape a grown woman. Hell no, you're not raping babies.
That's a different type of
that's
a different
another,
type of
that's another level. Like, come
bone.
On, that's
still,
a new level of rape.
Still,
like,
there is bone. No level.
All rape is the same.
Okay, well,
it's
I'd
horrible
rather,
either way.
I'd no rather you rape a grown woman than rape a baby.
You should not want to rape anyone.
Babies ain't a higher level than, come
shouldn't
on, not
rape
even
anyone.
Babies.
Wayball,
do you know what you're saying?
Shouldn't want to rape
Wayball, whoever rapes you is evil.
They evil as hell. They evil. They a demon. They a high-ranking demon.
If you have had a personal experience that you would like to share.
No, I'm just saying.
I'll listen to that.
I'm just keeping it real. I'm sorry. I'm in both seats. And rape, he gave me this motion.
Rape is just...
Here we go.
It's definitely the evil.
Rape.
Blame it on the shine.
Rape, murder, and child molestation, to me, are the worst three crimes of humanity.
Absolutely.
But they equally worse? Is not one that's higher?
No.
All of them deserve death penalty.
All of them's trash.
So all these teachers and stuff, like, the boy rarely, and I guess maybe he's too shy, but you rarely hear the teenage boys reporting, it's always the parents. That are doing these kids a certain way.
Are you talking about these? You talking about these middle schoolers who are getting their teachers pregnant?
Yeah.
Yeah, those little boys were taken advantage of.
That's what I'm saying. But nobody, they don't make a crazy.
Oh, no, rape is rape.
I'm just saying.
Rape like is one rape. Man,
I when y'all say it, y'all say it wasn't no levels. Y'all say no levels, but y'all kind of quiet about
Brian,
that.
I agree with
rape
you.
Rape is okay. Rape.
I agree with Brian because women do take advantage of young boys. Yeah. And when you talk to young boys, men who have been in that situation, they tell you it is a psychological thing with some of those guys that I've talked to. They do say it was a psychological issue with them.
Yes.
Some men.
Those 14-year-old boys. Those 14-year-old boys who are accosted by those 25-year-old women were taken advantage
very
of.
Lucky. Unlucky.
But do they tell, though? Like, most of the time, it's a parent.
No. That's what happens when it's a young man.
They don't
Somebody
tell.
Goes through their phone, and their parents are like, you took advantage of my son. Right. But there's not a young man out here who's 14.
Young boy say, you took my virginity.
Oh, yeah, you took it. You took it, right?
Right.
I lost my virginity.
And then I just want to go back.
It's not right.
You're right, though.
It's not right. But I'm going to have to bow down a little bit. Wait, man.
See, it's levels to this. But
your angle was wrong.
Oh, well, I might have said it.
That's why I can't.
I didn't feel through the same way. But basically, I'm saying the same thing. It's levels to this rape thing.
Had to give y'all some food for thought.
It is not as bad. I'm going out on a limb. It's not as bad when a boy is taken advantage of by an older woman as it is when an older man takes advantage.
Exactly.
Now, there's an argument. Well, if you ask a mother about her son, she would completely disagree with you. I feel that we.
Well, mothers have been wrong historically for a long time.
Yeah. And men has been equally wrong.
I'm just telling, man.
A long time.
Even Tupac said that. How can a mother raise a man? How can a single mother raise
a lady?
How can a mother raise a man?
How do you men feel about Russell Simmons' daughter telling him, if you don't continue to take care of me, I'm going to date a 65-year-old man, and that's what she went and, well, older man, she went and got a 65-year-old man. She's 21, but the man is 65.
Yeah, she just broke up with him.
Okay, no matter what she broke up
with, I don't see nothing wrong with that. I'm 65.
So you cannot turn down no 21-year-old. Yeah. Yeah, so you won't turn no 21-year-old down.
So you're fine. So I just want to find out how
if
you guys
21,
so you
it
guys
is what it is.
Are okay with your 21-year-old daughter dating a
DC?
Significantly
Ugh.
Older
can't
man.
Can't stop it.
I mean.
So, DC, how would you feel coming to Thanksgiving dinner, you got to go out of the country to visit Russell Simmons because he's never coming back, I don't think.
But Russell Simmons, if you're listening, Russell Simmons has called into the show before.
Yeah.
All right.
So,
Death Jam.
What's your question?
I'm saying,
is Diddy moving in?
Would you couldn't date his daughter and then go visit him for Thanksgiving and be like, yeah, hey, Russ, how you doing?
Why not?
I could.
How you doing, young fella?
Right.
How come you couldn't date his daughter and go to Thanksgiving? She's 21.
Well, is it now the rule is twice. I'm sorry, half your age plus seven.
Yep, that's the rule.
That ain't my rule. My rule is I got a 40-year-old daughter.
Okay.
I'm not going under that.
Okay.
Gotcha.
Under no circumstance.
Up. Yeah.
So if I go under that, my daughter, I got a 40-year-old daughter.
Mm-hmm.
So, your daughter's 40?
Yeah.
Man, I know.
So I'm not going under 40, for it's got to be 40 years in there. Now, if it's two girls and both of them 20, that's 40.
Hey!
We'll be back. You're listening to DISRACE. All right. All right. Man, let's talk about some happiness.
Yes.
Y'all went off on this very deep dark. So let's talk about what's happened. There was a very happy event that took place in America last week.
Okay.
A man married Siamese twins.
Oh, I saw that.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah,
Yeah, he did.
So let's ask some real questions, guys. Let's ask some real questions.
Let's ask.
They answered them.
They did answer them.
Twins had a form and they answered them.
What was the question?
Do they orgasm at the same time?
Yes.
Oh,
yeah. I never heard that question.
I didn't hear that question.
They got a whole form. I seen it too.
They did a whole form.
Like, we got two heads and one coochie.
They got one.
Two heads and one coochie.
I'm gonna say the thing what DC just said earlier. I read.
Just two legs.
Just got two legs.
How many legs do they have? Is that what you just asked? You thought it was a three-legged, two-headed?
They got two heads. Right. What the hell is more ridiculous?
They two women from the titties up. I think they only got two breasts, and then from there they just got two heads.
Yeah.
So now,
and when somebody asked them what happens when the other one decides to get married, they said they'll figure it out when it happens. But right now, they.
But that's the thing. You gotta be cool with. So she doesn't.
Both of them.
She doesn't. She's not in love with this other guy.
Who?
What the other part on the other line?
Yeah, which one? I don't know which one
is. I don't really know which is which. Is it the one on the left that married the boy?
It's the one on the left.
If you face on stage left or if you face
if you facing,
what are you talking about?
It would be his right hand, the left of the woman.
That's the one. The one in the middle. The one on the other side got a strong neck.
There's
only two of them. Don't confuse the listener. There's only two of them.
Hey, listen, man.
If you're facing her, she would be the
God
left.
God bless the handicap. God bless, for lack of a better phrase, on tip of my tongue.
The Siamese twins.
Freak. The freaks of the world.
Just say Siamese twins.
Nah, freaks. Everybody.
Oh, he's a freak. Listen, I'm going to tell you like this.
I ain't talking about him. I'm talking about them.
Right.
You got two heads. Come on now. Imagine this.
Yeah.
That's freaky. That's freaky.
Where we going, man?
That's
freaky. We're going
over
to the J house, man.
You ain't coming over my house.
She come mad, okay.
Yeah.
You ain't coming over my house.
She cook for me. She cook for me.
You ain't coming over my house.
All I'm saying is, which one of y'all eating the coochie?
On the outside.
You don't hurt me. That's why you get down.
What'd you say? Wait.
Which one of y'all eating the coochie? Because they say one of them, she be like, when I orgasm, she feel it too, but she just be thinking about other stuff.
But that's my whole thing.
No way, Bob.
She did say that.
And what they said, that was no more
moonshine for you.
No, that's a quote. That's a quote.
It's a quote. They had a question there.
Yeah,
and they came on online and said, answered it.
I pleasure my man, and yes, I give him head. And
she
yes,
right
I orgasm.
Yeah.
And with the other one right there.
Yeah.
So, did she take a nap? Why she?
Well,
they didn't say all that, but they answered all the questions they had. They did like a form, and the people was coming up with these wild answers. And credit to those women, they did not back down. They didn't dodge nothing.
But what if she's watching a movie and y'all just want to get started? What if I'm just here? I'm watching something.
I don't know if that was one of the questions, but you can go back and check.
Yeah. Oh my.
But they date night all that stuff. They
well, if you had your choice, which would you watch, Django or? Yo, Siamese twin.
I know. I put it like this. I feel like we're in a world now where everybody gets to be loved.
Everybody should have some love.
Everybody had love.
What if the other lady
fall in love with somebody? What's she supposed to do?
He'd just be sleeping on the other side.
Just be a foursome.
A foursome.
Come
you
on, man.
Thank you, man. I got it at 5 o'clock, and you get it at 6.
See, that's the society we live in. Y'all don't want to admit.
He might be in a science fiction y'all don't or something
wanna
like that.
Y'all don't want to admit nothing is crazy.
It's a dude out there that's going to marry the other one, though.
He predicted that, too.
Who?
Futurama. Who? Remember the show Futurama?
Yeah.
Where they're showing women with three breasts and all these other and aliens and everybody messing with everybody? Look, it's coming true, bro.
However, it does change the whole concept of head.
Ooh.
Two heads are better than one.
They say, what they say, two heads
are better than one.
Two heads are better than one.
If you don't get it right the first time, you got a second chance.
But I just,
did you
tell
the other one like you're doing too much? Huh? I said, did you tell the other one like, you're like, girl, you're doing too much. Wait on your sister or whatever.
I think about several other situations like that with Freaky D. I think Siamese twins ought to marry other Siamese twins.
Oh, wait a minute. It's
hard.
What?
What the hell be harder than your wife come home with two heads, man?
But he cool with
messing with another two.
But you know, that little people have relationships with normal sized people. I'm talking about midgets.
Yeah, but then they're more likely to have a midget.
They do.
They got a television show like that. Them midgets had them grown.
Yeah, they got
kids.
A whole little.
Them kids got 13, 14. They were beating them midgets' ass. Get your ass in and wash them dishes.
All I'm saying is, if I was dating a lady with two heads, I would try to get acquainted with both heads. Like, how you gonna come and tell your main lady, hey, baby, you looking beautiful today? She got the same outfit on. You might as well go on a cake with both of them at the same time and get two heads. And then why would I give one of them a compliment? Y'all hair done the same way. It ain't like one of them got some nappy kitchen and the other one got her hair done smooth. They get their hair done together.
Actually, that made more sense.
You might as well take with both of them.
They ain't the most beautiful women in the world, but I've seen worse looking women with just one head.
But I will say they the prettiest two-headed women I ever seen in my life.
Nice. Well, I wouldn't call them pretty.
Ain't a two-headed woman more fine than them.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
The only other two-headed thing I seen is a dragon, and that was just on like
that was today.
But DC did bring out something that I just realized. As much as I've traveled, many people I know, I've never seen a small person married to a normal sized person. I've never seen it. I know it's not Sister J, but I'm just saying I've never seen I don't want to see
and
the
you know, and you know what's really crazy? People think they're light, but they heavy like a kettlebell.
They look heavy to me.
Yeah, they real dense in the middle.
A kettlebell?
You done dated a little person.
You just said heavy like a kettlebell.
I'm a
Go over there and share that mic. Go over there and share that mic.
But they're not midgets, though. That's normal. I've seen that. That's not midget. That's a normal-sized woman.
I mean, it's still size.
I'm talking about the basketball player, like three foot seven
or something.
It's still size, relatively
speaking, it's the same.
Nah,
if a 6 foot man marry a midget, it's like a 7 foot man marrying a 5 foot tall.
Right, that's what I'm saying. It's about size, right?
Shaq's
because when
size.
when you got exactly
all the NBA players, most of the women are
not as tall as them,
not even close.
I didn't know that. Caitlin Clark,
if you're 5'9", even if you're 5'5", that's better than a short person with.
They're watching.
They're walking bow leg like their legs about this big.
They're watching.
Wait
Fix
a minute,
your
now,
hands.
We're not midget
your hands.
We're not midget haters now.
I'm just telling you that's
why. Well, you know what he's talking about.
Why are you doing that, man? They're not that.
Can you weigh in and just tell him it's different levels?
Give me one at a time. Go ahead, JJ.
No, I'm just saying midgets will whip your behind. You keep talking about them like
they
that.
Will.
There's
some tough midgets, man. Like little midget with the Universal Circus. He's a bad little midget. Not Tony Tone. No, a little midget.
Like I said.
Zeke.
Oh, Zeke.
Now, back in the day when I grew up in Chicago, before Mr. T became nationally known, they used to have a contest. Mr. T was a bouncer at the club. I forget the name of him. And they would have a contest in there once a month where all the bouncers, the contest was who could throw the midgets the furthest.
Oh, that's so disrespectful.
And now it's been declared inhumane.
Absolutely. That's something that happened in the 80s.
But it sure was
funny back then, boy.
But they land on something safe.
On a pad, yeah.
Okay.
On a mat.
They even got it where you put Velcro on them and you can throw them up against the wall.
Oh man, I like. I mean,
and sometimes I think society has made us overly sensitive because you see midgets doing a whole lot of stuff. They do wrestling, everything.
Now let's be very clear: these people are trying to work. They're
little
not.
People. You're not even supposed to say midget no more.
Right.
You're right.
Or y'all don't care. Or do your hands like this.
But that's the length of their legs. I'm not being funny. That's the length of their legs when I see a midget.
Because I saw one in New York one time, and I said, oh, man, he's a midget. He's like, don't call me a midget. I said, okay, nigga.
Man. So one time.
He's like, I'm not black either. Right. He's like, I'm not black either.
No, so it's like, so one time I'm out in Vegas, and we were like doing like a Super Bowl party. And I had a whole lot to drink, and I really thought I was hallucinating when I got on the elevator because Midget Kiss, the rock group, got on the elevator with me. And my brothers, I said, man, dude, I just got off the elevator with Midget Kiss. And they thought I was lying. And then later on, going down the strip, the next day, it was like Midget Kiss performing as such and such. I said, man, I told you I saw Midget Kiss. But they thought I was lying because they said, man, you ain't seen no Midget Kiss. But it was the rock group, Midget Kiss.
Yeah.
They had groupies and everything. Like, they got on. I'm freaking out. I'm like,
them.
And they were like, hey, you want
to
Midget Kiss?
Yeah.
You play the hand you dealt, man.
Yeah.
Nobody in here, nobody appeared, had anything
and they
to
performing
do with
Vegas.
How they got to this world.
Yeah.
If you come as a midget, God bless you.
Yeah.
You
come and they had a whole show on Vegas. So that's what I'm saying. I think they try to make us overly sensitive to it, but I think they don't care.
Yeah, you come as a midget, you come as a fat person, skinny person, light skin, whatever, black.
Yes. Okay.
Fat person.
Just get here any way you can.
Go on, get in front of that one. Get in front of that one.
Get here any way you can. Legitimate, illegitimate, don't worry about it. Because after all, Jesus was illegitimate.
And he was fat. I heard. I think he was fat too.
No, he wasn't fat.
Jesus was chubby a little bit. He was
140 pounds. But he was illegitimate.
He was light skinned though.
Am I right about him?
He knew who his father was.
That's not what legitimate means. Oh, they were not married. If they were married, she wouldn't have been married.
If Mary came to you and you're Joseph, Mary comes to you and says, Joseph, I'm pregnant.
Yeah.
And it's not yours, but I need you to really work it out with us. Yeah. It came from heaven. You good?
No, I'm good. I'm
he
good.
Wasn't
I
good with
I got on my ass and rolled the hell up out of there.
I'm talking about me.
God bless Joseph. I got on my ass. You rode the fuck up out of Jerusalem.
Talking about God.
Her ass is a donkey.
That's
a donkey in biblical terms.
I'm sure the Holy Spirit
knows that. Who the hell don't know that?
They might not understand it.
We'll be back. You listen to Satanic Tim Young. We'll be right back.
He said. Thank you.
in the world of crime, man.
Y'all are stealing.
Los Angeles, California.
L.A.
There was a heist that took place last week. These boys went through the wall.
Jacking.
Of a Brink truck company and got $30 million cash. Didn't set off no alarm. Got in the safe. I never even heard of such. I never heard of somebody having $30 million cash in a, no, I ain't. In a building? No, I have
Ocean's
not. In
11.
Fact,
oh, that's what I'm saying.
I'm talking about in real life.
Oh, okay.
I went to the bank one time, and I wanted $50,000 cash. This is the bank. Told me, we don't keep that kind of money around here. You can come get it tomorrow. We'll order it.
Right.
The bank told me.
The bank, yeah.
You know, most bank robberies, they be getting like, oh, $5,000,
$10,000. Yeah, it ain't no crazy. Right.
$30 million in this warehouse in Los Angeles.
Somebody
and
got
they
tipped.
Went through the wall, didn't set off the alarm, got in the safe, didn't set off the alarm, got the money, got out of there. Ain't no pictures of them. And you got $30 million in a warehouse, and you don't have no security.
You think it's insured?
No, I'm talking about, I would have, not only the cameras, I would have somebody watching the cameras, then I would have somebody else watching the people
and
that are watching
and
the cameras.
And four Rottweilers watching
and
them.
And the dog.
Yeah. And you know, when
I have four Rottweilers watching them, period.
When you see the drone footage of the building, it looks like a regular-ass building. Ain't
a
no
regular-ass, like you store it.
Right. Look like
you know, like where you got
that simple.
Like
that means they come in and cut the power.
Where you got your mama's furniture after she got divorced and moved to a small
So that it makes sense then. I mean, it just makes sense then. If it's that bad, I mean, if it looked like that,
it's an inside job, man.
Maybe.
It's an inside job.
Maybe
you go through the wall.
Yeah.
You set off no alarms.
Cut the power.
You get in the safe.
Not a steal.
You in an area where there ain't no camera. Ain't no pictures. Ain't no security.
They cut the
ain't
power.
Ain't no pictures.
I like this, and now you're a ninja.
It's an inside
He's like,
job.
They cut the power. They were.
Y'all made it simple. Y'all the one that made it seem like it's just like a little you store it. So who can't cut the power till you store it?
I mean, there's no. When you look at something like
I bet
that,
you ain't no $30 million in you store.
I don't right. know. They done found some Lambos in them things.
All them old ass couches and sofas. And
hey, I mean, hey, you look, whoever did the job, they went back to work the next day too.
Stop it.
Really went back to work the next day.
Ain't nobody selling $30 million
over the order. No, that's the only way you won't get caught because whoever don't come back to work
keep the
is
same
the thief.
Routine.
Yeah.
Keep the same routine.
Okay,
you're probably right.
DC, you about to start a heist. You about to go on a heist. Who you taking with you? Who's gonna be the three that you go on this $30 million heist with?
I take Richard.
Oh, Richard's reliable.
And me.
And how many more?
You get three more.
I probably take cooking.
She's small. She can get into places.
Y'all are clowning.
You gonna put cookie in the air vent. Yeah.
Would you take Sister JJ?
I take Sister JJ.
Why you want to take me? Huh? What you mean? For what?
All they gonna have to do is catch one strand of the blue hair. They gonna know who it was.
I'm the distraction. I'm the distraction.
Y'all gonna get caught. Y'all getting caught.
What you mean y'all gonna get caught?
All day.
No. Don't take me.
You sound so mad.
Getting caught all day every day.
No, Cookie. You see what it was, Cookie? He got mad because he knew he gonna take Richard because Richard got him all the way around. He know women. We know.
Smart.
Come on, man.
Come on, man.
Come on, don't make me go thug on y'all. Y'all break it the drop of the dime. 25 years. DC did it. You know what I'm saying?
We snitches now.
Cookie, they didn't got to say 25. They say 5 years.
He wasn't taking nobody's break.
That's a damn show. Hey, 5 years.
I don't need to be a part of the heist. I would expect it to be called.
I can pray afterwards.
You not taking the clergy with you?
Oh, hell no.
Nah. Don't need me. We don't need to get struck by lightning.
Struck by lightning.
They're like, got him.
Man.
We know that slogan.
Oh, man.
Yeah,
they got mad. You know what I'm saying? They got mad.
sister be like, sister, this
look
is hot.
Look at Cook. Look at Tim hating
hard.
Why you
sister Tim hating? Be like, that dude hot. My makeup run. I can't do this.
Tim hating hard.
What you blame me for?
Sister JJ, why Sister JJ? Yeah.
Because
yeah.
You can't
I
do it.
I stay over here chill.
All
you
units,
know what I'm saying?
Your units are always
so bright. Yeah. I give you several reasons for Sister JJ. Go ahead. She's streetwise.
Okay.
What do I got to do with that?
You going to need
she's
that.
She's a major distraction visually.
I'm just saying. That's, well, I mean, I'm just saying.
Pour a little bit of that pousse on the ground. Yeah. Take them off the scent.
Then she comes with an assortment of disguises.
That's right. That's right.
And showing the video, and then later on, they identify as all the suspects, and they be like, "Well, who's the one with the blonde hair?"
That right.
Exactly.
That's right.
Yeah, who's on the blonde hair? No, that ain't the
That's
group.
Right.
That's
right.
Not the group.
That's right. You go with the winning team, DC. Go with the winning team. You ain't trying to get
JJ,
locked
tell
up.
You ain't no snitch. You ain't telling on
y'all
nobody.
Y'all know I ain't no snitch. No. I got 50 thong.
Can't go till you get hungry. Damn, wait, I don't know why y'all coming for me online today. I don't know why y'all online.
They coming for you from last
saying.
Week.
Number one. I will get seen on camera because I got a way, I got a gate with my walk that you can tell who I am. Like, it's no way for me to walk into a bank and they be like, that's who that is. It don't matter if I got a mask. It don't matter what I'm mask. They can tell my waddle and they be like, that's weight ball. Based on, we done seen him waddle. It's only one nigga in on earth with
but
that
remember,
type of waddle.
But remember, we're not talking about a bank now. We're just talking about somebody. Y'all might can pull off this as a warehouse.
But now,
Mike can pull it off.
We're talking about a, what is it, Garda is the group. They go around and they pick up money from different businesses.
Yeah, like,
and like a Brinks truck. They store that money. Yeah. Clearly, a situation like that should be heavily guarded. But
you would think.
I mean, I've seen the guys who drive those trucks.
Come on,
man. The guys who drive those trucks really don't give a fuck. Yeah.
They look like me.
They don't know.
It ain't their money. Oh yeah. It ain't their money. It ain't their money.
Come on.
They look like everybody.
But you know, who would think it's $30 million in that building?
Somebody knew it.
Somebody knew it.
It's an inside job.
Yeah. But you think it's insured, though? You think the money's insured?
I hope.
Up to a certain amount.
We'll see.
Yeah, what is the FDI?
But now that's a crime that I would consider doing.
Well, $30 million. When you rob somebody, you got to rob somebody.
I wouldn't rob nobody.
Talk about a corporation.
I'd rob that building.
Yeah.
Right.
Just rob the building. I
wouldn't feel bad about being falsely accused of boy. Wasn't that Howard? Harold Johnson just got out of prison, been in prison 34 years for a crime he didn't commit to brother.
Mm-hmm. You never see white people spend 30 years in prison on mistaken identity.
I forgive everybody. Man, I'd be like, man.
I'd be mad.
He getting paid now.
You get a check now. You
he about to get paid. He about to get paid.
That ain't enough. 34 years.
That's your life.
You
that's
can't
your entire
pay
life.
Me enough.
No, yeah, you can't pay me enough, man.
Nah.
I'm
see, that's
my
what I'm saying, DC?
Life.
You picked the right team. He can't. They can't do five. They be like, as soon as they get locked up, DC did it. DC told
me. Oh, so you would do it, too? You'd be the
DC
man.
DC
doing
it. Soon as they come with the handcuffs. DC did it.
Like, have you ever seen Uncle Elroy?
Yeah.
Like, have you ever seen that Friday?
Yeah.
Right. He was the man with a cigar.
Yeah. See, no. DC already know I'm trying to test it. So y'all ain't trying to test it.
So
I'm
you
trying
want props that you can take a bid.
We got to go. I didn't get to
yeah,
Angel.
Yeah, they snitches.
We didn't get to Angel Reese and Caitlin Clark.
Revenge versus revenge.
You know Caitlin Clark got a boyfriend?
To cape on to
top. Like, that's so surprising.
Oh.
Well, I'll say this.
She's going to have more boyfriends. More offers now.
Oh, yeah. Caitlin Clark got revenge on Angel Reese, and then my girl from South Carolina got revenge on Caitlin Clark.
Well,
revenge.
I'm going to tell you, man.
Raven Johnson.
I'm going to tell you, one of the worst calls I've ever seen, when they called that offensive foul on that girl.
In the semifinal.
It was clearly. Yeah, that was a bad call.
We want Caitlin Clark in the final.
Well, let me ask you this. Yeah. I know we got to get
18
out of here.
18 million views.
But do you feel that the Caitlin Clark story has overshadowed all those women from South Carolina winning the championship?
I don't think so. If you follow South Carolina enough, I think they give
it
on our show.
To my argument that I've had on this show several times with the less intelligent.
I don't know what you're talking about, but if you go with this John Cena, Angel Reese thing, I promise you, We need to let it
go. Did you notice how the coach of South Carolina, Staley, what's her name?
Don Staley. Yeah.
Did you notice how she handled it? She fixing to make a shitload of money.
Oh, the way she congratulated
Caitlin. She said, I'd like to thank Caitlin Clark.
She just signed for $22 million. How much more money going to pay her?
Who signed?
Don.
Okay. Now, what you think she would have got if she'd have said, Caitlin Clark?
Fuck off.
Right. You can't fuck with an angel, bitch. Get out of here, bitch. I'm telling you, Rev.
She was like, "This shit. Caitlin's the reason that we are all here. Why all these people are here today and all
she's
that."
God bless. She was just praising the universe. I'm sorry about the lightning that hit the Statue of Liberty.
I just whooped you. I can praise you now. I just
whooped
you.
She was saying that was my fault. The lightning that hit the Statue of Liberty. That was my fault.
Now,
God bless Caitlin Clark. I'm finna to tell you, cha-ching, cha-ching.
Right.
She just got $22 million.
So now let me ask. Now,
so what you saying? You always be bringing
I'm
up them numbers.
With you. I'm saying she got
that's
20
enough.
Million, but I don't know. I don't know if it's because of her.
She gonna get 50
beating.
More million.
Mm-hmm. Why? Because she just said, "Hey, Caitlin Clark, thank you." And now Caitlin Clark going to
the Yeah, absolutely.
Y'all are. It doesn't.
I
work
mean,
that way.
How does somebody from where you are from not know how to
it
bow
doesn't
down?
Work that way. But I'm definitely not, I just whooped you after you put me out. I'm not gonna bow down. I'm gonna say good game and I'm gonna congratulate the girls that I coached. Which clearly the same I'm just saying, why are we talking about we weren't talking about
why
that?
You get no endorsements from Adidas. You and I got endorsed. What did it say? DC?
Yes.
You endorsed it?
Listen. Yeah, I'm trying to find DC. Out. So before we go into that, so we're not going to talk about that. The same girl that Caitlin Clark waved off last year saying you can't shoot came in and locked
what
her down.
Your argument is based on this universal thing that it's the same to be white as to be black.
I'm not saying
I hate
that.
To disappoint you, Rem, but it ain't.
I understand
that white
that.
Girl can do that all day long and get them $50-100 million endorsements. You cannot do that. Now once you retire, you can say what the hell you want. I was privy to be in a meeting. I knew Michael Jordan, one of Michael Jordan's sisters, very well. Mm. They used to have meetings with him and tell him, don't say shit, and he did it. Don't say shit about politics. Don't say shit about social issues. Right. And play basketball, and we're going to get this money.
Well, you play it like that, but again, though, going back to, like, right now, ain't nobody getting Raven Johnson. Raven Johnson, it's the revenge tour. She stuck to it. She's still sticking to the revenge tour, and she like ain't nobody bashing her. I just think that because Angel Reese just did it right there as they were winning for all the kahunas, I just think people just got their feelings about it, and Angel Reese just embraced it. And so y'all are just, I just think y'all are just criticizing her for no reason.
It cost her millions.
Yeah, it did. Yeah, it did.
She's now she's second to Caitlin Clark.
Your argument has been before how many t-shirts she's selling out her trunk.
No, I pointed that out. But at one point, at one point before Caitlin Clark this year, Angel Reese was the highest paid in NIL deals. She was the highest paid until Caitlin Clark got to the tournament.
Caitlin just made $910. She's going to give up $3 million to the WNBA.
Ice Cube offered her $5 million.
She's still going to the WNBA.
So y'all ain't
going to
talk about Angel Reese announcing through Vogue? Y'all, so I guess Angel Reese just broke. Y'all just, I'm just
no,
saying
she
like,
ain't broke.
Vogue, she announced her commitment to the WNBA on Vogue.
Levels of broke. They said Michael Jackson was broke.
I guarantee you Caitlin Clark
he
won't get
broke like you and me.
I guarantee you Caitlin Clark won't get
not
bold.
With that Adam's apple she won't.
She won't get bold.
Did you forget you owe me some money? What are we talking about, broke?
I mean, I do, but still, though. I do, but what are we talking about, though?
Well, I'm saying we were talking about broken.
Yeah. But we got Michael Jackson broke and Caitlin Clark broke.
And Reverend
I know, but
broke.
I'm saying they're not broke like you know.
Like, I'm just saying.
Broke. I'm saying.
Okay. So all I'm saying is, what's wrong with Angel Reese getting Vogue? I'm saying, what's wrong with Angel Reese getting Vogue and Caitlin Clark?
Shut it down for this nigga commit suicide. You've been listening to DISRACE.
Oh,
you've been listening to DISRACE. I'm DZ Curry.
I'm Sister JJ.
I'm Brian Harper.
I'm Tim Black.
Weight Ball, happy to be here.
And your man, Bullhead. Slam alaikum, eat my
bark. Special shout out to Cookie Hall and hanging in there with us. And Carla, the sandwich lady from time to time.
Like and subscribe.
We got Mike Eaton, we got Will Gladine Smith, and we got head of security, Richard Torrance. We'll holler.